Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're going to continue our talk on vectors. As stated before, a vector is just a quantity that has both a magnitude and a direction. We're going to actually do an application, actually apply vectors to a real world situation. All right, here in this word problem, a third baseman releases a baseball with a speed of 32 feet per second at an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal, and we need to find three different things. First, express this vector in terms of I and J. Second, find the initial speed of this baseball horizontally, and three, find the initial speed of this baseball vertically. We're going to begin by doing a simple drawing of what this word problem depicts. We're going to start off with our XY axes, and then here we're going to draw our vector, which I'm going to call W, or name W. And we see from the problem that this baseball is being released at 30 degrees. All right, with that, you see that I can create a right triangle. And with that right triangle, I have special properties available to me. So I'm going to redraw this right triangle over here to do the work, and we'll transfer it back to our depiction. All right, this here is 30 degrees. I know this right angle is 90 degrees, which means this angle up here has to be 60. With this special triangle, I know opposite 30, its relationship is x, opposite 60 is x root 3, and then opposite the 90 degrees, or the hypotenuse, is 2x. Also from the problem, we know that the length or the magnitude of this vector W is 32. With that, I have two corresponding sides. In this case, it's the hypotenuse. I have 32 is equal to 2x because these two sides correspond. I then have an equation I can solve. I can divide both sides by 2, and then here I see that x actually comes out to be 16. With x being 16, although the right hand side of this triangle is 16, which means this side here is 16, and I know the bottom or the horizontal side of this triangle is actually 16 root 3. All I did in both cases is replace the x with what I found to be 16. All right, with that, now I want to come to just labeling some of the pieces that are given to me. The way that you show the magnitude in proper notation is the name of the vector with two vertical bars on each side, so we know that there is 32 based on the problem. And they also gave us theta, which is the angle at which the baseball was released, and that's 30 degrees. All right. Now we need to show vector W in terms of I and J, and that's going to be the magnitude times cosine theta I plus the magnitude of W times sine theta J. And now we just do a basic substitution. Magnitude is 32. Cosine, we see theta is actually 30 degrees I. Again, the magnitude is 32. And we substitute in 30 for the sine, I'm so sorry, 30 for the theta, so it's sine 30 J. And now we see with cosine 30, we're able to actually figure that or resolve that by hand. Cosine is the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. So in this case, it's going to be 16 root 3 over 32. So again, let's rewrite. 32 is in the problem. And cosine, as we said, is 16 root 3 over 32. And don't forget your horizontal component I. Plus, now we work on the second term, 32. And the relationship for sine is the opposite side over the hypotenuse. So in this case, it's going to be 16 over 32. And that's going to have J. And then we can start to resolve this. To make the multiplication easier, I see that I can cancel out these 32s. I'm left with 16 root 3i plus. For my second term, I can again cancel out the 32s, and I'm left with 16j. So here I've completed part one, where I've taken vector W and I've expressed it in the components I and J. Now I want to work my way to number two. I know that the I component here is the horizontal component. So to figure that out, I just need to multiply 16 times root 3. So let's call up a calculator and take care of that. As you can see, I've already done it. 16 root 3 is the same as 27.7. Actually, it's approximately 27.7. So let's use the squiggly equal sign. So 27 and 7 tenths. And our units here are feet per second. So I'm going to use feet per second or FPS. This here is for part 2. So we're seeing that horizontally, the baseball is moving at approximately 27.7 feet per second. And then we'll make our way to part 3. And part 3, this here is our vertical component. That vertical component doesn't have to be, there's no conversion necessary, it's just 16. So vertically, the baseball is moving at 16 feet per second. So this here sums up this video on finding the vector expressed in terms of I and J and the magnitudes or speeds of a particular object moving horizontally and vertically. Thank you again for watching the video by Spello Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name. Thank you again for watching.